Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss third fat soluble vitamin, that is vitamin E. Learning objective for today's video are, first we will see chemistry and dietary sources of vitamin E, then biochemical functions of vitamin E, and in the end we will discuss deficiency manifestation of vitamin E along with various NEET PG MCQs. To download lecture notes and other interesting stuff related to biochemistry, please visit website biochemistrybasics.com. Before going in the detail of vitamin E, let's see example of questions that can be asked from this particular topic in theory exam. Long answer question like, what are antioxidant vitamins? And write a detailed note on biochemical functions, sources and deficiency manifestation of any one of them. Short notes or brief answers like, antioxidant role of vitamin E. Active vitamin E was isolated from wheat germ oil and it was named as tocopherol, where tocos means childbirth, feros means to bear, and ol stands for alcohol. Vitamin E consists of 8 naturally occurring tocopherols, of which alpha tocopherol is the most active form. This is the structure of alpha tocopherol. There is a presence of chromain ring, and to the chromain ring, isoprenoid side chain is attached. Now, dietary sources of vitamin E. So, the major dietary sources of vitamin E are fats and oils, and the richest sources are germ oil, corn oil, sunflower oil, cottonseed oil, eggs, and lettuce. Fish liver oils are devoid of vitamin E. Now, nutritional requirements of vitamin E. So, daily consumption of about 10 mg of alpha tocopherol for the male and 8 mg of alpha tocopherol for the female is recommended. And 1 mg of alpha tocopherol is equal to 1.5 international unit. So that is all about recommended dietary allowance and sources of vitamin E. Now we will see biochemical functions of vitamin E. Vitamin E acts as a natural antioxidant by scavenging free radicals and molecular oxygen, and it is considered as one of the most powerful natural antioxidant. Vitamin E is important for preventing peroxidation of polyunsaturated fatty acid present in the cell membranes. It also protects the erythrocyte membrane from the oxidant effect. It is the major role of vitamin E in the humans, and it protects the RBCs from the hemolysis. Now we will see interrelationship of vitamin E with the selenium. Selenium is the trace element, and it is present in glutathione peroxidase, which is an important enzyme that oxidizes and destroys the free radicals. So selenium has been found to decrease the requirement of vitamin E and vice versa, and they both act together to minimize the lipid peroxidation. Vitamin E also helps to prevent the oxidation of low density lipoprotein. Low density lipoprotein is the bad cholesterol. Oxidized LDL may be more atherogenic than the native LDL. Thus vitamin E may protect against atherosclerosis. In animals, vitamin E is required for the normal reproduction and prevents the sterility. That's why it is also called as an anti-sterility vitamin. Whether vitamin E affects the human fertility is unknown. Now, deficiency manifestation of vitamin E. So first, we will see in which persons vitamin E deficiency can occur. So examples are, first, you cannot absorb the dietary fat. In premature infants whose birth weight is less than 1.5 kg, in A-beta lipoproteinemia, and in mutations in the gene for the tocopherol transfer protein. So these are the persons in which vitamin E deficiency can be seen. Now we will see deficiency manifestation. The major symptom of vitamin E deficiency in the humans is hemolytic anemia, which is due to increased red blood cell fragility. Another symptom of vitamin E deficiency is retrolental fibroplasia, which is observed in some premature infants of low birth weight, and the children with this defect show neuropathy. Vitamin E deficiency causes poor nerve conduction, spinocerebral ataxia, retinopathy, peripheral neuropathy, and myopathies. Now, hypervitaminosis E. At doses above 1000 international unit per day, it may cause tendency to hemorrhage as it is a mild anticoagulant. So that is all about vitamin E. Now we will see various multiple choice questions. The first question is, vitamin E is responsible for all the following except, and the options are, it prevents lipid peroxidation in biological membranes, it prevents RBC from hemolysis, it is considered as anti-sterility vitamin, and it favors the oxidation of LDL. So all the options A, B, C are correct. D, it is wrong. So the correct answer is D. It doesn't favor the oxidation of LDL. Second question is, which one of the following minerals has a sparing effect on the dietary requirements of vitamin E? The options are copper, chromium, selenium, and iron. So the correct answer is selenium. We have already seen interrelationship of vitamin E with the selenium. Third question is, dietary requirements of vitamin E is elevated with the increased consumption of, and the options are UFA, saturated fatty acid, cholesterol, and proteins. So the correct answer is polyunsaturated fatty acid. That is A. Fourth question is, the most powerful chain breaking antioxidant, and the options are glutathione peroxidase, alpha tocopherol, superoxide dismutase, and vitamin C. So the most powerful chain breaking antioxidant is alpha tocopherol, and other chain breaking antioxidants are superoxide dismutase and catalase. So alpha tocopherol is the most powerful chain breaking antioxidant. So the correct answer is B. These are my references. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit. And don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from it. Thank you.